In some situations, it can come in handy if you can find a root note by ear. For instance, when you play at a jam session or you're going to play a song you've never played before and there are no sheets available. Unless you have an absolute pitch, it will always be a guess which notes are in the song. But you can start just guessing, or you can do an educated guess. In this video, we focus on this last type. This action plan I present can be used for instruments that can produce low notes, like a bass guitar, but also for piano and guitar. For any instrument, actually. This action plan will protect you from guessing around by playing lots of notes on your instrument, which are probably lots of the same notes, and doing this to the point that you might get stuck. You do not need to have a lot of music theoretical knowledge to work with this. Well, let's find out the root notes of the chords in this progression. Step 1. Find a note that fits in the key. For this step, you actually have to play only one or two notes. Because when your first note is out of key, it means that the note one semitone lower and one semitone higher will sound in key. So, we choose a note, C. We play it. It's not in key. If you're not sure about it, it can help to play it one octave higher. So, we move one semitone higher, C sharp. Now we found a note that's in the key. Step 2. Write down the musical alphabet. We'll start from the note that we already know it's in key, C sharp. Now we have this overview, we're going to check if notes need to be raised or lowered. You play the note while the chord progression is playing and see if it fits the key. So, C sharp, D, E, F, F sharp, G, G sharp, A, and B. Now we found all the notes that are in the key. This is your starting point. You may not know which scale you are playing, but you see that it actually doesn't matter. Also note that you can combine step 1 and step 2. Step 3. Write down the bars. In this step, you're going to check out how many bars it takes before the chord progression gets back to the starting point. In this case, it takes 4 bars. You write this down to represent the bars. When it appears to be a lot of bars, it could be handy to break the progression down into different pieces. Then you can, for instance, first take a look at the first 4 bars, then the second 4 bars, and so on. Step 4. Fill the bars with the root notes. Now we know it's a 4-bar progression and we know the notes that sound in key, we have a clear puzzle to solve. There are 2 efficient ways to do this. Take 1 bar and try out all the notes that are in key. We'll take the first bar and start with the note C sharp. We play it only at the first bar. If it does not seem to be the root note, we move on to the next note. C sharp. Sounds okay, but might not be the root. D. F sharp. We now know that F sharp is the root note on the first bar. We write it down. Now, let's take a look at the other possibility. Take 1 note and try it out on all bars. We already know that the note on the first bar is F sharp. If you listen closely, you can hear that this chord is not repeated in this 4-bar progression. That means that the note F sharp isn't used twice. so there are 6 notes left that can possibly fit in the remaining 3 bars. Let's start again with the note C sharp. Move on to D. E. Two bars to go and 3 possible notes left. G sharp. A. B. We found all the root notes. Let's listen to it. So this is a way to find all the root notes by ear. It might take some training to clearly hear if a note is in key or not in key. Another note than the actual root note of the chord can sound fine too, and it could be an artistic choice to choose that note. Not all songs use only notes that are in key. Sometimes notes that are out of key are used in a particular bar. Don't worry about that. If you hear none of the notes in key sound right on that bar, keep in mind that there are only 5 notes out of key, so you will be able to find it quickly. Once you know the root notes, you can start playing along. If you'd like some tips and tricks for making grooves or improvisations, check out SV Method.